Hello friends, welcome to Dev's Institute. Today we are going to talk about spread spectrum, FHSS and DSSS. Before I start, I request you to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet and click on bell icon to get instant notification. It's absolutely free of cost. Like multiplexing, spread spectrum also combines signal from several sources to fit into a larger bandwidth. Spread spectrum is designed to be used in wireless application, wireless LANs and WANs. In wireless application, all stations use air or a vacuum as a medium for communication. Stations must be able to share this medium without interception or an eavesdropper and without being subject to jamming. Idea of spread spectrum. Spread spectrum techniques add redundancy, that is, original spectrum needed for each station is spread if the required bandwidth for each station is B, then spread spectrum expand it to BSS such that DSS is very very greater than B. Source is wrapped in a protective envelope. So this increased bandwidth allow us to add extra bits, and that we call it as a envelope. Like we wrap a delicate expensive gift in a special box to prevent it from being damaged. So this is the diagram which explains what is spreading of spectrum. So this is your original message with bandwidth B. This original message passes through the spreading process. Spreading process has one more input called as spreading code. Now see, this spreading code is irrespective of this data. Means this data and this code doesn't have any relation. Just we need to increase bandwidth of this data by applying this spreading code or by spreading the data. So this is the original data, this is spreading code. After adding spreading code, we'll get this much of bandwidth, data with increased bandwidth. This BSS is very very greater than B, and this allows the message to be transferred securely to the destination without intervention. There are two techniques for spreading the bandwidth. First is frequency hopping spread spectrum, FHSS, and second one is direct sequence spread spectrum, that is DSSS. FHSS technique uses m different carrier frequencies that are modulated by source signal. At one moment, signal modulates one carrier frequency, and at the next moment signal modulates another carrier frequency. Although the modulation is done one carrier frequency at a time, m frequencies are used in long run. The bandwidth occupied by source after spreading is BPHSS, which is again a greater, very very greater than B. Now we'll see this process in detail. So consider this is original message. Now original message has to be converted into modulated message so as to be transferred through the signal. We all know the concept of modulation and demodulation. So in modulation, we combine original message with the carrier signal and we get the modulated signal. Now for carrier signal, every time after some amount of time, we change the frequency of the carrier signal by using this frequency table. Okay, so there is one algorithm which will generate pseudo random code, and by using that code will select one of the frequency, and a carrier wave with that frequency is given to modulator. Now original signal will be modulated with that specific frequency and you will get the modulated signal. After some amount of time, this carrier frequency will change. So this code generator will generate specific code or different code every time, and different frequency will be selected, and that different means every time different frequency will be used for carrier signal, and your original signal will be modulated every time with a different frequency carrier signal, so that you will get the signal with a variable bandwidth. We'll see it with the help of example. Consider that these are numbers generated by this pseudo random generator, this block pseudo random generator. So now for first time, pseudo random number generated by pseudo random generator is 101. For 101, frequency is 700 kilohertz. So at time t1, okay, at time t1, data will be modulated with the carrier frequency 700 kilohertz. At time t2, data will be modulated with frequency 900 kilohertz. At time t3, data will be modulated with 300 kilohertz, and lastly data will be modulated with 600 kilohertz. So every time, for every cycle, every change in the cycle, carrier frequency changes and thus results in change in the bandwidth of the data to be transferred. So now see here, for FHSS cycle, for first cycle your data will be in this frequency. These are the carrier frequencies, so your data will be in 700 band, data will have 700 bandwidth. In second time it will be 900. For third cycle, for third period, it will be 300, then 200, then 400, then 800, then 500, and then 600. Okay, and this same pattern is used here. So again for next cycle, so when this last one 100, that is 100, that is 600 is done, again data transmission with bandwidth 700, 900, 400, 200, and will go on. Okay, so we have studied FDM earlier. In FDM what happens, this is the entire bandwidth is divided into four channels. F1 is one data signal, F2 is another, F3 is another, and F4 is a fourth data signal. So F1 continuously uses this bandwidth, F2 continuously uses this bandwidth, F3 uses this bandwidth, and F4 uses this bandwidth. So this is entire bandwidth of a channel divided between different signals F1, F2, F3, F4. This is FDM. So F1 will be modulated with carrier signal of this frequency, F2 will be modulated with carrier frequency of a carrier signal with this frequency, F3 will be modulated with carrier signal with this frequency, and F4 will be modulated with carrier signal with this frequency. This was in FDM. Now in FHSS, frequency hopping, see, for first time F1 will be modulated with this yellow frequency, then for time 2 F1 will be modulated with green frequency, then time 3 F1 will be modulated with blue frequency, and time 4 F1 will be modulated with pink frequency. So these are the frequencies. In FDM frequency remains same continuously, and here frequency changes. So for F1, for time 1 this is the frequency, for time 2 this one is frequency, for time 3 this one is the frequency, and time 4 this one is the frequency. So for, as F1 is using this yellow frequency, the rest three frequencies are free and that can be picked up by F2, F3, F4. Similarly here F1 uses green frequency, so rest of the three frequencies are free and that can be picked up by F2, F3, F4. So there is algorithm to select the frequency for the carrier wave. So this is how your frequency hops from one frequency to another during time intervals. That's why it is called as frequency hopping spread spectrum. Then next one is the direct sequence spread spectrum, that is DSSS. DSSS technique also expands the bandwidth of the original signal, but the process is different than FHSS. In DSSS, we replace each data bit with 11 bits using spreading code. In other words, each bit is assigned a code of 11 bits called chips, where chip rate is 11 times that of data bit. Now we'll see how this happens. So actually, direct sequence spread spectrum is very easy to understand. This is original signal. To the original signal will apply the chip generator, and your original signal will be modulated, and it will be a spread signal will be generated, and spread signal will be traveled through the network. So now we'll come directly to the example. See, this is original signal 101. This is my spread spectrum, which is 11 bit. What is my 11 bit spread spectrum? 10 11 0 111 3 times 0. This is my spread spectrum, and this is common. This is fixed. 10 11 0 111 0. This is my 11 bit spread spectrum I have considered for this communication. So now 1 will be coded like this, 0 will be coded like, spread spectrum is same, so 0 will also be coded like this, and 1 is also, 1 is coded like this. Now I'm using polar NRZ scheme, so this signal will remain as it is. For 0, it will be inverted, so this 1 will become 0, 0 will become 1. You may be knowing polar NRZ scheme, and this 1 is again represented as it is. So 1 is represented as it is, means this spread spectrum, means this 1 is converted into equivalent, or the spreaded into 11 bits. So this 11 bit sequence means 1. Inversion of this means 0, and again this bit sequence means 1. So this is about the FHSS and DSSS. I hope you understood concept of spread spectrum. If you have any doubts, you can ask me through comment section. Thank you very much.